Fresh off his literally dozens of felony convictions, Donald Trump has apparently admitted to violating a key consequence of him being a felon and maybe admitting to an additional crime along the way. So an official who was briefed on the pre-sentencing meeting that Donald Trump had earlier this week told CNN that Trump admitted to still possessing one of the three firearms listed on his New York City permit to carry concealed weapons. Two of the three pistols he was licensed to carry, we previously discussed, were handed over to police back in March of 2023 after his gun license was suspended in light of his arrest by the Manhattan DA's office. The third gun, though, was lawfully moved to Florida. This is according to the source. Who knows if that's even true, but that's what they're saying. Presumably to Mar-a-Lago, where Trump was for the remotely conducted hearing. So he had the license for three guns. He was supposed to turn all of them in. He turned in two and just decided no on the last one. It's mine. You can't have it. It is, however, and this is an inconvenient truth, I guess, for Donald Trump, a federal crime for someone convicted of a felony to possess a firearm or ammunition. And apparently he does. Or if he doesn't, he's certainly not being forthcoming with the change in status of his firearm or where it is or who he gave it to. Did he sell it? Did he give it to one of his kids? I don't know. I do know that Palm Beach police told CNN that they were not told of any gun that Trump might have, and none were turned over to them since his conviction in May. The New York City Police Department has now notified police in Florida and asked them to take appropriate action. And that's where things, I think, become potentially very interesting, maybe spicy, certainly dramatic, because he's not supposed to have these guns. It is a clear violation of the law. And yet the NYPD can't go take the gun. They're not gonna raid Mar-a-Lago. They have to go through Florida police. And now that this story is out there and it's making headlines, what are we, maybe 10 minutes away from Ron DeSantis weighing in on this? Do you think that the Florida police, or that to the extent that Ron DeSantis can control them, would actually go and take that gun, demand that he comply with the law? Maybe, I hope so. I find it a little bit hard to believe that they're going to do that. They've already said that although he's not supposed to necessarily be able to vote in this election, they're going to change the regulations to allow him to. That's what Ron DeSantis and the Florida Republicans are going to do after spending years trying to stop former felons from exercising their right to vote. They're willing to totally 180 on it for Donald Trump. I expect that they'll do the same thing for guns. And I don't even know for what. What does Donald Trump need with that gun? As we discussed earlier this week, the very idea of him holding a gun is utterly ridiculous. The guy's only comfortable holding slices of chocolate cake. Come on, he's not gonna use a gun. He doesn't need a gun. He's never gonna defend himself. And he's not legally supposed to have it. By the way, on the topic of guns, I wanna have fun for a moment. I wanna remind you that he once promised the NRA that he would reverse President Joe Biden's gun control measures. You know, all of those gun control measures that he's passed. It's just every day it's another gun control measure. But anyway, he has long bragged about his guns and what he would do with them. Following the terrorist attacks in 2016 in Paris, he told a French magazine that, quote, "I always carry a weapon on me." And that if he was there, he would have opened fire on the assailants. If he was caught in the middle of a deadly terrorist attack, oh, he'd go John Rambo. He'd be diving in front of civilians, trying to absorb the fire, protecting the innocent, bravely firing back at those terrorists. That's what he would do. But look, even if he wants to have his hero fantasies, I don't even see why he would care if his gun would be taken away, because he's been on the record before that he doesn't even need a gun to be a hero. Here's what he said in the wake of the Parkland shooting.
You know, I really believe you don't know until you test it, but I think I really believe I'd run in there even if I didn't have a weapon.
I know that I say this pretty much every day, but that's the most ridiculous thing that he's ever said in his life. Look, maybe the terrorist attack in Paris is more ridiculous. He's not going to defend people with a gun. He's certainly not gonna run in there without a gun. I mean, I know some of you might be MAGA and you think that he's brave and you think that he's got like the V lines on his abs or whatever. You see him in a way that has never been true and never will be true. But come on, you have to admit that that's a joke, that he's not gonna do that. The guy, like, he went so far beyond the bounds of what should have been acceptable in avoiding serving in Vietnam with his lies about education and bone spurs and all that. And ever since, he's made a mockery of those who actually serve and talking about avoiding STDs being his personal Vietnam. He is a guy who has never done anything more physically strenuous or brave in his life than like maybe recovering one of his like stray golf balls from the brush. Like who, what hero? He doesn't even exercise and you think that he's going to take down a mass shooter. But anyway, I digress. For now, he at the very least should not have that gun. Okay, he needs to turn it over. And I also, in closing, just want to say how ironic it is that the right, who admittedly, they're not all that excited about the fact that Hunter Biden was just found guilty of gun-related charges, but they at least accept that he should be. They think that he did violate the law, that if you don't apply the law or don't follow the law when it comes to your guns, you could potentially suffer the consequences as a result of that. And we're like days off of that verdict. And we find out that Donald Trump is risking it too. And by the way, I don't know that I believe that he will suffer any legal consequences for this. Maybe they'll turn it in. But if he does, is this not like the most stereotypically Trumpian legal problem to cause for yourself? That you just don't give it back? I mean, it's like a stack of classified documents next to his toilet. He doesn't need to have it. There's no reason for him to have it. He's not legally allowed to have it, but it's mine. But you can't have it. Who are you to take away my object? And like, I would imagine that if I were a MAGA person and I was seeing this right now, I would think like, can you not make it so easy for the other side to prosecute you? Stop willingly violating the law. He doesn't carry the gun. He doesn't need the gun. Just give it in, you stupid idiot. When you click the join button and become a tier 2 member, you get access to all of our weekly top 10 lists. What are you waiting for?